Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to this video, guys. My name is Liaquat Zaman, and we are going through the series of the Quran. Now we are in Surah al-Baqarah. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. مثلهم كمثل الذي استوقد نارا فلما أضاءت ما حولهم ذهب الله بنورهم وتركهم في ظلمات لا يبصرون صم بكم عمي فهم لا يرجعون. Allah here in this ayat mentions an example. After mentioning about the believers, mentioning about the disbelievers who openly show that they disbelieve in Allah and show animosity towards the believers, Allah mentions about those who were hypocritical. Those who on the outward would say they're Muslims, but when it came to the reality of it, when it hit home in their hearts, they had hatred for Islam. They had disgust for Islam. Allah then mentions an example, a beautiful example that summarizes things for us, that puts things into perspective, gives us an image, a picture. What's that picture? Imagine this. مثلهم, the example of them. كمثل الذي استوقد نارا, like the example of the one, a person who comes in a dark night and he ignites a fire. Imagine this. Everything around that fire is going to become lit up. أضاءت ما حوله. It begins to light up all the things around. Imagine you light a fire or you light a candle inside of a room. You can see the chairs, you can see the cupboards, you can see the window, you can see the roof, you can see all the things around start to become more illuminated. ذهب الله بنورهم. Allah says, after He showed them the light, Allah says, Allah took away their light. تَرَكَهُمْ فِي ظُلُمَاتٍ, and left them in darknesses upon darknesses upon darknesses. لَا يُبْصِرُونَ, they were unable to see. This is the example, my respected brothers and sisters, example that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gives us of those people who reject the message of Allah. They have the faculties of hearing, they have the faculties of seeing. And when Islam and the teachings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they come to a society, it removes all the darknesses from that society. It's meant to remove racism. It's meant to remove inequalities between people who are believe that they are superior to other people. It's meant to show that everyone is equal in the eyes of Allah. So this divine message that came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is something which is, subhanallah, this is a light for the entire community. Everyone, from the scientists to the philosophers, to the rulers, to those who are working, to the average person that works on the streets, a taxi driver, a shop owner, a teacher, a student, Islam is a light. It illuminates their lives. And what kind of a light is it? It's not like the light of the sun that you can see with your physical eyes. It's a light that creates good character inside of people. It creates inside of them a character, traits that are pleasing to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you don't have this, then Allah will take this away. If you do not show appreciation to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's light that He gives us, Allah, He will take it away and Allah will leave you in darknesses. Imagine, have you ever looked at the sun and then all of a sudden looked away from the sun? What happens? You begin to see everything as dark. For a split second, everything becomes dark. A person who sees the light of Islam, knows this is the truth, and deliberately goes against it, then everything in their life will become affected, like that darkness that they go through. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then He says, summun bukmun umyun. These people are as though they are sum, as though they cannot hear. Bukmun, as though they cannot speak, they are mute. Umyun, as though they are blind. La yubsirun, they cannot see anything at all, meaning they cannot see the truth anymore. And everything that they do, all the policies that they make, all the institutes that they set up, all the countries that they develop, all the work that they do for their societies will all be based upon ignorance, will be based upon bias, will be based upon all of these things that Islam tells us to remove from our societies. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, summun bukmun umyun fahum la yarji'un, that they will not return. In other words, so long as these people do not go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they cannot return to becoming on the right path. Now may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the reality of this, my respected brothers and sisters, because Islam, the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we only have one chance at this. You know, our death, the time that we will leave this world, is something which is unknown to anyone at all. And so each one of us has this responsibility of searching for the truth and making their lives better for themselves and for the community as well. So what do we learn from these verses? Number one is that Allah, He gives us examples so that we can ponder over them, that we can think. With an example like an image, it creates 1,000 words, better than 1,000 words. The second thing that we learn from this is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the example of the one who lights the light is like the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He comes to put the light on and he came to the people of Mecca and they refused and rejected him. And what happened? Allah took that light away and he transferred that light to another city that would appreciate him, the people of Medina, the Ansar. And that light grew and that light illuminated the entire world from this place. And then number three, the thing that we learn is that the more we show appreciation to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's message, the more illuminated we will become and the more illuminated our society will become. And the less appreciation that we show, then the less we become illuminated, and the less illumination that we have, the more darknesses we will live our lives in. And this is, you know, something that we need to think about in today's times. Thank you very much for watching this video. Thanks to all my patrons for all the support that you guys have shown. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you people. And any of you guys want to show support through Patreon, links in the description below. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you very much to all my patrons. Jazakumullah khair. Alhamdulillah. You know, with all of your support, with all of your efforts and your encouragement and motivation, alhamdulillah, this channel has reached where it has today. And there's so much left that I want to do, and there's editing, and there's, you know, trying to start new projects as well and get other people involved so that I can focus on producing content. So, you know, if you guys want to become patrons and you want to support this channel, then check out the link in the description. Inshallah, there's also videos available for those who are patrons in the Patreon itself that I don't put on my normal YouTube channel. So if you guys want to check that out, inshallah, links in the description, like I said. And jazakumullah khair, share it with other people. Let me know what you guys think as well. And assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.